for those of you already on the holiday break, well, we've got an early gift coming your way tonight with some college hoops action as the Lopes host Mississippi Valley State live here at GCU Arena, which is where we're coming at you right now. I'm Kate Longworth, courtside here. Happy to have you along for the ride here on 3TV, and especially happy to welcome back Tim Ring. We had a lot of fun covering some big wins last year. It's great to see you back here at GCU territory.
Yeah, Kate, really is great to be back. Great to have GCU on 3TV for the second straight year. It's our second of four games this season. Next one coming up on January 21st. We're really excited about tonight's game because it's winning time. You know, you look at that GCU schedule right now. Yeah, they're 5-5, but the hard part of the non-conference schedule is certainly over. And as great as the Louisville game and the Arizona game and the Duke game and Pitino's comments and Miller's comments shed a positive light on the program, now it's time for Dan Marley and GCU to win some games. They have five non-conference games before WAC play begins. I think they have a chance to win all five, and it begins tonight against Mississippi Valley State.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, and I think you want to be strong those final five games before you enter conference play, because GCU's ultimate goal is to win the conference, because they are in that final year transition before they're eligible for March Madness next year. But I don't want you to overlook, they are winning, and they're winning here on 3TV. Last Saturday, they took care of UIC, the final score 76-72. Now, there are some schools out there that are having trouble beating UIC.
Yeah, I know. I'm about to disown DePaul University, all right? I'm gonna start calling myself a GCU alum. Yeah, we lost to UIC. You have to bring that up. We did beat the tar out of Chicago State today. Proud member of the WAC,
mind you, by about
100 points.
Well, your alma mater could not handle UIC, who GCU handled. However, my alma mater, they did take care of the Lopes earlier this week. However, after the game, Sean Miller had a lot of praise for GCU.
In my 8 years, I've never seen a section in McHale filled with the visitors. I mean, they had a whole section, and you could hear them cheering, and you just tell they got a great spirit about what they're doing, and that's to Grand Canyon's credit. You know, I made the comment earlier this week, we didn't play Grand Canyon to like help build their program or do them a favor. If playing us helps build their program, you know, great. We played their team because we respect them. They had 27 wins last year. They have a couple guys injured, and on a given night, they can beat anybody, and they're going to be really good in their conference. So we did that to help us, and that's the greatest compliment you can give them. Not, hey, you know, we want to help you get started. We're playing you because you're good, and we respect you.
Strong words from University of Arizona head coach Sean Miller. Those words alone carry a lot of weight. Then when you look at them coming from Sean Miller and the strong Pac-12 powerhouse that Arizona is when it comes to basketball, and then now these two teams can be interstate rivals. So that's a pretty big compliment to Dan Marley and the program he has going.
And there's no doubt about it, Kate. Remember, GCU is short-handed. Josh Braun is not playing, but yet they gave U of A all it could handle down there at McHale. Let's get into the two men who will call tonight's action, Barry Butel and the former Tar Heel, Scott Williams.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, what a great, great game it was down in Tucson at McHale Center. 64-54, the final score. Both teams probably could have played a little bit better on both sides, but boy, the Lopes went toe-to-toe.
Well, I like the way they compete. Yeah, that's the biggest thing of this stretch of games. When you talk about Louisville, San Diego State, and of course that Arizona game, is Coach Marley shorthanded has gotten his guys believing if they compete hard, they'll be in ball games. They certainly were.
There you see it, within 4 points, 10-22 of the second half, and 44-40. It was a back and forth battle. The second half, 3 points weren't falling. Darian Clark goes down with that injury. He's going to be out for a couple of weeks now, as that right shoulder was popped out and popped back in.
And they're going to miss his rebounding in his toughness, in his experience as a fifth-year senior.
Well, a couple of guys are going to have to step up. We've seen Dwayne Russell do it all season long, but how about the freshman, Oscar Prayer?
The fearless freshman kid did it again. Struggled in the first half against University of Arizona, but came back strong in the second half. He was absolutely phenomenal, scoring all 16 points. He was 6 of 13 from the field overall, but he was 6 of 8 in that second half by taking the ball to the basket, shooting the long ball. He just really bounced back. A lot of young players would hang their head and go into a shell. in the second half of a ball game after being scoreless in the first half. This guy shows a lot of moxie. He goes out there and continues to fight.
There you see his numbers, 16.3 points per game the last three. Leads the team with 9 blocks. Does Oscar Freyer. He had a highlight dunk here the other night that, boy, he knows how to put on a show. But we know that this guy puts on a show just about every game. That's Zero the Hero, Dwayne Russell. Boy, has he been carrying this team with John Town.
Right, he's really been fantastic. His last 3 ball games been an absolute monster, scoring the basketball with a number of drives from the basket. The floaters working, shooting the long ball much better. The crossover dribble to the mid-range pull-up, and he's getting into paint and dishing and finding his bigs underneath. Just playing great basketball.
24.6 points per game. You see the assists. He leads the team in that category. 14 of 35 from the arc. Dwayne Russell, 79 total points in the last 3 games. He'll be carrying the load here tonight as the Delta Devils of Mississippi Valley State come to town, just like they did last year. This is a program that, for revenue generation, they got to hit the road, and they're 0-10 coming in.
0-10, they went 0-14 to start the season last year. But don't sleep on this team. I mean, they play some of the big boys of basketball too. You know, West Virginia, Michigan State, Indiana, Gonzaga, they play them all. So folks can't look past this team. I mean, they're not have enough experience and enough talent on that floor. They have to compete to win basketball games. I think that's something Coach Smart is going to stress to his troops this evening.
Well, one guy that we're probably going to keep an eye on tonight is Rashawn Searles. He's a senior point guard for the Delta Devils.
Yeah, Searles is going to kind of have to be the man. He scored in double digits last year, a little bit slow this year, only 9 points a game. 2.4 rebounds. He's only 4-for-21 from 3-point range. So look for him to try to get himself going behind that arc, provide an offensive punch.
Steals, blocks, also free throw percentage. He leads all 3 of those categories for Mississippi Valley State. Well, as we mentioned, Tim did off the start a couple of non-conference matchups, 4 in a row here on their home court. So it'll be nice to perhaps make some hay against the Delta Devils as we begin the first of 4 here at GCU Arena. Guys, back over to you.
Well, guys, that's certainly what the Lopes are hoping for, a big win tonight. But I wanted to go back a little to Sean Miller's comments. Very strong about the student representation down at University of Arizona. He said the student section for the Lopes had an impact on the game. So I was wondering, do you think if that game had been here at GCU Arena, the result might have been a little different?
Yeah, I think so. I believe the Havocs is a real thing. It's a true advantage, home court advantage for this Lopes basketball team. It rattles other opponents and it energizes the GCU basketball team like no other home court I've ever seen before. You play U of A here next year, I think it's a different outcome.
Yep, U of A had a couple of guys injured as well. They were playing with a short bench as well. You never know. San Diego State went home losers here before the team traveled to Tucson.
Sounds like they're putting the challenge out. Sean Miller's listening. Scott Williams just said next year here.
What a couple homers those two guys are, huh?
Just wait, Tim. Wait till tip-off. I think you'll be wearing the purple pride, too. All right, well, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with the Lopes pregame show here on 3TV. Tim sits down with Dan the Man right after this. And we talked about the schedule makers not being kind to the Lopes. There have been some strong games on the schedule. But what's it mean to the program? Tim finds out right after this. You're watching Lopes pregame show here on 3TV.
Grand Canyon University proudly unveils the new GCU golf course, featuring over 7,200 yards of expansive tees and tree-lined fairways, signature par threes, greenside bunkers, premium greens, and a brand new clubhouse and restaurant. Experience a university championship golf course with affordable rates right in the heart of Phoenix. Book your tee times at gcugolf.com. Christmas from Grand Canyon University.
And we're back. Be sure to get your GCU men's basketball tickets now. They make great stocking stuffers. Single and single game tickets are on sale now. Just 3 more non-conference games are left at the GCU Arena in 2016, plus some great WAC conference matchups starting in January with Utah Valley, New Mexico State, Seattle, and CSU Bakersfield. They are on the schedule. It is a great place to bring the entire family. Reserve your tickets now by contacting the GCU box office at 602-639-8979 or go by lopestickets.com. And we are back. We welcome you into GCU basketball. Great to have you along here on 3TV tonight as GCU plays host to Mississippi Valley State. Tim Ring alongside the head coach of the Lopes, Dan Marley. We're going to talk about the Delta Devils, Dan, in just a bit. But let me talk about your club here now in mid-December. We all know what trips to Duke and U of A and hosting Louisville. We all know what that does for the program. But tell me what it does for the players in terms of making them better on the court.
Well, I think it's important because I've always said that we want to be a top 25 team, and you have to play top 25 teams to see how they react, how they play, how hard you have to be, how better we have to get. And you've seen we've made great strides in that area. You know, we went to Kentucky a couple years ago, got blown out. Went to Louisville last year, got blown out. We were able to stay within nine, Louisville. You know, last game we were at U of A, a very hard place to play, a team that's ranked 19th in the country, and we're right in the game and we end up losing by 10. So we've made progress of playing against those really good teams, and we know where we want to get.
Well, Dan, if you are a college basketball fan, just kind of dipping your toe into the season after the college football season ended, regular season, Oscar Freyer is a freshman for you. He's 6'7". Boy, this kid, he's got some skills. He really can play.
He can really play. He's done a great job for us. And what was very impressive the other night against U of A, he went out and had a really bad half. It was 0-for-5, didn't score. And a lot of times, especially for a freshman, he's going to shut it down and have a bad game. He came out in the second half, had 16 points, was more aggressive, taking the basket. A real good athlete, plays extremely hard. And the best thing about him is that he comes every day in practice and really plays hard, very vocal, and wants to get better.
Yeah, 19 points in that big win right here against San Diego State. Dwayne Russell, look, he made national headlines, Dan, with that 42-point night against Louisville. But you guys are asking him to pick up the scoring now across the board in every game because Josh Braun's not in the lineup yet.
Yeah, and it's hard for Dwayne. I mean, he plays 40 minutes, never comes out of the game. He's 5'11", 150 pounds. He's keyed on by everybody that we play against. So he's just a tremendous player, an ultimate competitor, and we're lucky to have him. He really worked hard on his shot this year, and you see the dividends as he's really shot the ball well and has done a great job. And it's going to be tough for him all year because I said they key on him, but he does a terrific job of not only getting his own shot off but drawing players and finding other guys.
Dan, give me an update on Darian Clark, who hurt his shoulder in that loss to Arizona on Wednesday.
Yeah, it's the same shoulder that he had problems with before he came here. Had surgery when he was USC and went for a loose ball, and it popped out. It went back in, and he's going to be a guy that's probably out for a minimum of 2 weeks. Walking around with a sling, so we'll have to see how it goes. But a tough injury for him because he's had that surgery before, and you'll probably have to have it again after the year. But he's been a tough kid, worked hard. So it's just we're down to seven healthy scholarship guys.
Yeah, you're down to seven, which means no silly fouls, right?
Yeah.
Don't reach and go straight up when you're playing defense in the post.
Yeah, we're going to have to do a good job of playing hard without fouls. We still want to be really good on defense. I think we've made good strides there. And then we're going to have to ask some of the walk-ons to step in and play well for us. And they practice hard every day, so it's going to be an opportunity for somebody to step up.
All right, so Mississippi Valley State comes in here tonight, Dan. Let's not sugarcoat it. They're 0-10. They're losing by an average margin of over 27 points a game. So let me put it to you this way. When you talk to the team in the locker room before they take the floor, what's the message going to be?
Well, the message is they are 0-10, and they do play really good competition. They play a lot of road games. They have to get by games. But the reality of it is if we don't come out and we don't play well, we'll lose to anybody. We have to come out and play our type of game. We have to play extremely hard. We have to execute. This is a team that's going to really junk up the game. They press all the time. They switch defenses. They play a zone. They play a man. They go for steals. So this is a team that can get after you, and if you don't play well, you'll find yourself in a ball game.
You know, Dan, I mentioned it last segment. You know, you look at it right now. You guys are 5-5. You have five non-conference games left. Obviously, the goal is to hit WAC play with a record of 10-5.
Obviously, but as I said, we have to do a good job of winning games. We have winnable games here at home. The students are on break. We still expect great crowds here, but we have to come out and play well. Being 5-5 right now is not bad, because especially with the injuries we've had and suffered all year long. So I'm happy with our record right now. But as you said, we would love to be 10-5, but we're going to have to play really well to get there.
And one game at a time. Here's a stat that I found that I thought
you should
was interesting.
Be a coach.
Right? You guys, you're 54-6 when you shoot better than the other teams. You know what that tells me? shoot better than the other team.
Like I said, you're a hell of a coach.
All right. There you go. We're taking a quick break. When we come back, Kate's got some stuff on the GCU TV, guys. From humble beginnings, just a few short years ago, GCU TV has blossomed into one of the top student programs at the university. We'll show you some of the great things that they're doing when we come back. GCU basketball tonight on 3TV.
It's that time again. Time to be thankful. Time to be with loved ones. A full calendar and a full plate. Family Christmas and family traditions. The years go by fast. And the holidays, even faster. Now's the time to make room for what's really important. Giving back and going forward. Building memories and creating a better future. This is your season. Seize it. GCU's online degree program puts you first, so you can make the most of your time. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. GCU.edu.
All right, we are back here on 3TV. GCU Lopes basketball tonight. The Lopes welcoming in the Delta Devils of Mississippi Valley State. The Delta Devils, a tough go of it so far. They are 0-10 on the season. The arena starting to swell to capacity now. And what an advantage this arena has been for GCU. Did you know only one team in the entire country in Division I had more home wins last season than GCU? Only one. GCU 18-2 in this building this year. Meantime, if you're sitting there at home and you're a high school student or you're a youngster and you might want to think about maybe doing something like this for a living, you might want to put GCU on your radar. They've got a pretty good TV school going right now. Kate Longworth has more on that upstairs. Kate, take it away.
Well, Tim, you're absolutely right, and I know you and I can remember college just like it was yesterday. It was, right? Well, anyhow, we know how important it is to get that hands-on experience, and that is exactly what GCU TV program is doing here. You'll see them all around campus at any event, whether it's a weekend sporting event, Monday chapel, or just a random day and time documenting something happening here at the GCU campus. Well, GCU TV finds a way to always be live on the scene.
So GCU TV is a digital video platform. It's a lot like a traditional TV station, except for the fact that it's all done over the web. And the content is from all different aspects of GCU. It's basically, you know, you've got your athletics, events, chapel, all kinds of things that are happening on campus. And then there's also another layer of more like a traditional show. So we have things like coaches' shows, Finding Tatum's Purpose, Ending Faith, which is a spiritual life show. And so it's that mixture of things that are happening on GCU's campus, things that are of interest to GCU, the GCU community.
It's something that was really, really supported by everyone at GCU, and that includes the president, President Mueller. He's been able to give the resources needed to deliver the platform. Obviously, we needed a staff that was put in place in probably the last 2.5 to 3 years. And then it also took the support and enthusiasm of a number of GCU students to get behind the effort, and they're really a huge driving force behind the platform.
Working for GCU TV, I do a variety of different jobs. I work for all of the sporting events. We do broadcasting. I help work with the cameras. I do replay. I even got the chance to be the technical director for a couple different games. And then I also do different things in the office with editing. We do social media pieces, Finding Tatum's Purpose. We got to help with commercials. Just one of the things I love about working for GCU TV is the extreme variety of work that we get to do.
I think the real world experience is really good. You see a lot of qualifications and requirements on job applications, and they can seem overwhelming sometimes. And I think that the real world experience that I'm experiencing right now will give me that, and knowing that even though those things are on the qualifications guidelines, that I know I can do them because I've learned them here at GCU.
There is so much that I get out of working here. I love the environment that GCU TV provides. I think that all of the student workers and all of the workers are so helpful in teaching editing and teaching camera work, and also letting us be a part of that and being a pretty essential part in making videos for GCU students and prospective students that want to come look at the school. I think that it is a really great opportunity to work here.
GCU TV is both a place that the community can look to find things, and it's also a way that we can basically shine a light on all the amazing things that are already happening here. So it's this place in the middle that connects the greater GCU community with other parts of the community, and we're a conduit really to help people become more aware of what's going on.
Absolutely incredible what Barry Boutel has been able to do with his staff, and obviously you heard the support coming from Brian Mueller and also those student workers. I feel so lucky that I get a chance to work with them day in and day out and see their work all the time. It makes me think that one day they might be sitting here in my job. I hope not too soon. If you want more information on GCU TV, check it out online. And coming up after the break, we still have plenty more coming on the Lopes Pregame Show. Be Kind America is an organization based in Arizona that teaches today's children some very core values. We have all the scoop coming up right after this here on 3TV.
Christmas from Grand Canyon University.
Hey Phoenix, it's Thunder Dan Marley, head coach at Grand Canyon University. Coming to GCU was a great move for me. Join Antelope Nation by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors in small classroom settings where you can get the support you need to excel. Scholarships available. See you on campus. Go Lopes.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
Welcome back to the Lopes Pregame Show here on 3TV. While you're watching the game at home and you have your phone in hand, be sure to find us on social media, Instagram and Twitter. Use the hashtag LopesRising, and who knows, your tweet could be on the bottom of the screen. You could be a part of our broadcast. I'm Kate Longworth back here with the Lopes Pregame Show on 3TV, and I'm joined now by Anthony Kelly of Be Kind America. Thank you so much for joining us, and can you please explain to the audience at home what Be Kind America is all about?
Okay, cool. Well, Be Kind America is part of an initiative that we created with the Be Kind People Project. So we saw that the country was going in a bit like of a, we want to compare the country to like a boiling pot of water. So what we wanted to do was add ice cubes and hopefully create some relief through kindness. So it's a campaign where people can donate, and when they donate, we're able to give classroom kindness kits to kids all around the country with materials such as this. This is a card right here with our Be Kind pledge on it. It's a promise they make to themselves in order to carry out things, you know, on their own. So we build students up as leaders, and then we kind of put it on them to carry out the next generation of kindness. So yeah, it's really good.
Yeah, it's awesome. It has some of these things like be encouraging, be supportive, be helpful, be honest. Some great core values. What do you notice in students when they are instilled these values at such a young age to go into the working world?
Well, at a young age, we want to give them the opportunity to know that whatever, no matter where they come from or how old they are, they have a voice and they can create positive change. It doesn't matter if you're in kindergarten, if you're in third grade. If you're in third grade, there's still people that are younger than you and they're looking up to you. So we let them know that everybody comes from a different area and they all have different skills and talents. So it's up to them to use that talent to create positive change. So, you know, like there's like Marvel superheroes. They all have strengths and weaknesses, but when they come together for a common cause, they create really, really huge changes. And it's awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. Instilling confidence in kids and letting them know they have a place in this world. And take me through what your relationship is here with GCU.
GCU, we've been able to collaborate in certain ways. Like right now, we're going to perform at the halftime game and during a timeout. And we've also been able to pair up with Thunder at certain events in the community. And we've just been working really well together, you know, just providing that high energy, like the little Lopes Clinic and stuff like that. So it's been a real nice collaboration between each other.
Well, thank you so much, Anthony, for being here. A very strong message, especially during the holiday season. Be sure to check out what Be Kind America is all about. And we look forward to seeing you more during the game as Be Kind America performs. And we will be back with more Lopes Pregame Show as Tim Ring joins me on the other side. 3TV continues. We're talking college hoops, and it keeps on going right after this.
I'm Dominique. I'm a student here at Grand Canyon University studying hospitality management. My hospitality courses here are giving me a high quality education from professors that I know have been successful. Being able to work while I'm in school has enriched my college experience. I feel like I know where I'm going and what I want to do. I've gone through things I can't necessarily be taught, and so that paired with everything that GCU is doing for me, I feel like, you know, is setting me up for success. To have someone say, like, I want you, that's like a lot for someone like me. They're changing people's lives. By changing my life, now you changed my little brothers and sisters because they saw that I went to college. It'll just be, you know, my greatest accomplishment, not just because it's a diploma, but because, you know, I did what no one really thought I could do. When they say, find your purpose, they mean it.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back to the Lopes Pregame Show, where it is the purple pregame party happening right now. Live look inside GCU Arena as Tim Ring and I, Kayla Worth, get you ready for tip-off. And there's some exciting men's basketball happening right here inside the arena for the next couple weeks. So if you're on holiday break, make sure you check out what the Lopes are all about. Plenty of opportunity to get down here and show off the Lopes pride. They are at home this Tuesday and Thursday. You're looking at Alcorn State and UAPB coming here. Then we take a quick break for Christmas and Cal Poly here then on the 28th. 7 p.m. tip-offs for all that, and we hope to see you out here. Well, the students are out of town. It's great for local fans and community to get out here and cheer on the Lopes.
Yeah, looking at that schedule, too. You know Dan Marley. He gave me the one game at a time bit. He wants to be 10-5 heading into
the
WAC.
You reach between the lines very well.
There's no doubt about it. Now, speaking of the WAC, let's take a look at what's going on around the WAC today. Lamar, a winner over UTRGV. That game was played last night. West Virginia today, a winner over UMKC. Mentioned that DePaul score earlier today. The Blue Demons, a big winner over Chicago State in that game. And New Mexico State right now leading ASU across town by two. 40-38 is the score right now.
Yeah, we'll definitely be keeping an eye on that, get that score throughout the game. And coming up just moments away is tip-off right here for GCU, trying to keep their win streak at home going, and they're pretty lucky when they're on 3TV.
All right, looking forward to Dwayne Russell having another big night, and the freshman Oscar Frere, look out for him. 7 o'clock tip here on 3TV.
All right, well, don't go anywhere. Tip-off right after this.
It's that time again. Time to be thankful. Time to be with loved ones. A full calendar and a full plate. Family Christmas and family traditions. The years go by fast. And the holidays, even faster. Now's the time to make room for what's really important. Giving back. And going forward, building memories and creating a better future. This is your season. Seize it. GCU's online degree program puts you first, so you can make the most of your time. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. GCU.edu.
I'm Dewey, a student here at GCU studying communications. My dad graduated from GCU in 2009, and he is definitely bleeding purple. He loves GCU to the max. Me choosing to follow in his footsteps was the best idea I could have chosen. The program they had here and the direction it could take me was exactly what I wanted and what I needed. I am a GCU Lope, and I will forever always be one.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
This is our place. From here on out.
Hey, this is what we played before. We're better safe. Come on, let's go.
Come on, go get him now. Let's go.
Look.
live from the heart and soul of Phoenix, welcome to the campus of Grand Canyon University and inside GCU Arena, where tonight the Lopes start a four-game homestand as they play host to the Delta Devils from Mississippi Valley State. Good evening and welcome to GCU basketball. Alongside three-time NBA champion Scott Williams, I'm Barry Butel. Kate Longworth will be along in just a moment. Well, the Lopes returning back to the friendly confines of GCU Arena after a 10-point loss down at McHale Center against the University of Arizona.
Yeah, they might have lost by 10, but they really competed hard. I mean, this was a four-point game with a little more than 10 minutes to go. They had a great contribution from Oscar Freire in the second half, and Durain Wessel was doing what Durain Wessel does, scoring that basketball. He went for 19 points in that game.
Tight game throughout. Both teams playing very well, and Darian Clark goes out with that shoulder separation. He's going to be out for a minimum of a couple of weeks. So other players, again, will have to step up. And one kid that has stepped up since he took the court his freshman season, that guy, Oscar Freire.
Yeah, the fearless freshman. We talked about him starting slow. Most guys are hanging their heads. They go into a shell. A big game on the road. But this kid came back. He was 6 of 8 from the field in the second half, knocking down a three-point shot. Took the ball to the hole. Numbers, buckets inside. Love that alley-oop right there, that high handoff from Martin.
16 points. 3 rebounds, 2 of 7 from the arc, leading the team with 9 blocks. Oscar Freire from Oakland, California. The Delta Devils, they begin their season on a very lengthy road trip. They start 0-10. Rashawn Searles, their senior point guard, leads the way.
Yeah, Searles going to really have to pick up his scoring tonight, because I know GCU is going to up-tempo this game. He used to be a double-digit scorer a year ago. He's at 9 points, 2.4 rebounds. He's got to worry about him behind the arc. He's only 4 for 21 right now, but I know he's going to add that to his arsenal because they're missing their big guy, Marcus Roman, who's out for an undisclosed reason.
All right, well, it's time to get this thing started. The first of 4 on the home court as the Lopes come in overall 5-5. Let's send it over to the public address announcer, Paul Venuser, with our prayer and our national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to GCU Arena in tonight's men's basketball matchup between the Mississippi Valley State Delta Devils and your Grand Canyon University Antelopes. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you all please rise. Gentlemen, please remove your caps as we begin this evening's competition with a word of prayer. Tonight's prayer is led by youth and executive pastor of Love International, John Ramos.
If you please join me in bowing your heads. Father God, we come before you. We thank you for another night that you've given us, another day of life. I pray that we have a good game tonight, God, on both sides, and safety for both teams as we go out and just enjoy the life that you've given us, God. I also pray for the refs, God, because last time I was here, they said no one prays for the refs. So I pray for the refs, God, that you give them safety, that you give them vision, give them clarity, and that we just enjoy tonight and everything that you've given us today. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody help me say amen.
Thank you, Pastor John Ramos. Fans, please remain standing as we now honor America with the playing of our national anthem. The Star-Spangled Banner will be performed this evening by the Thundering Herd Pep Band under the direction of Paul Cook. Thank you. Thank you.
The Thunder ain't heard the band, their national anthem, and John Ramos, the senior pastor at Love International, with our prayer. Mississippi Valley State, the Delta Devils, 0-10 to start the season all on the road. One neutral site game as well. They are led by Andre Payne in his third season, spent 8 years at Wiley College in Texas as head coach and associate AD. Eric Struthers and Adia Curry are his assistant coaches. For the Delta Devils, here are Coach Payne starting five. Daryl Riley, Rashawn Searles, Kylan Phillips, Vasha Vaughn, and Tejay Henry.
Yeah, we're gonna look at Daryl Riley. He's a 5'10 guard, 155-pound freshman from Milwaukee. His job tonight is to try to stop Russell. He's gotta use his quickness, stay in front of Russell, not let him get into that painted area where he can toss up his little floaters and find the big man underneath.
Let's introduce him to Grand Canyon University.
Keontae Vernon tonight, because this guy always impresses me when he's on early. 15 points, 15 rebounds against UIC Flames. He got off to a quick start. Then comes back 1 point against the U of A. He's an elevator man. He's got to be more consistent over these next five non-conference games for the Lopes if they're going to be 5-0 on that stretch.
5-5 overall, 3-2 here at GCU Arena early on. It is fourth season as head coach, Dan Marley, the associate head coach is Todd Lee, the assistants Chris Covello and TJ Benson, director of basketball operations, and Luke Dallariba. There he is, Zero the Hero, the leading scorer for the Lopes, 42 in 40 minutes against Louisville. Time for your three keys to the game, Scott.
Well, you know, I went and saw that new Star Wars movie last night, Rogue One, and that's exactly what this GCU team has to do. They have to be on the offensive first. Get aggressive, attack them, get on transition by rebounding the basketball, finding shooters on the perimeter and taking the ball to the hole, into the muddy Mississippi. Get dirty on defense tonight. Be the more physical team right from the get-go, and then trust the force. That's right. You see this Mississippi Valley team in front of you, sometimes you say, oh, I'm gonna lick my chops, they're 0-10. Time for me to get my numbers. No. Trust Coach Thunder Dan Marley's game plan. Don't go all Han Solo tonight. Just do your job and do it effectively.
There you see head coach Dan Marley. The officials are Ronnie Hernandez, Wilson Holland, and Brad Fowler. Fans will remain on their feet until the Lopes hit their first bucket. Cheerleaders are here. The Thundering Herd pep band is here. Many of the students back home with their families. Hopefully they're watching here locally on 3TV, on ESPN3, GCU.TV. You can find it wherever you are. Lopes basketball. Freyer wins yet again an opening tip. Back to Dwayne Russell. We are underway.
I bet you're in this number, this little freshman number three here. They come out with a little half-court press, but Riley's got his hands with a full with the number three score in the nation and Russell tonight.
They do. Back to Russell, back to his left where he finds Freyer. He comes back out front. They do, looking up the shot clock. 7-6, driving, pushes back. Martin, open look for three. Short, rebound, pulled down by Daryl Riley. Quickly, out for Vaughn. Would have loved to seen Jared hit that three. He's just been extremely frigid.
I like he has, but you got to forget about last game. Kid doesn't do you any good tonight. I like the fact that he had the confidence to take that open look.
Searles pushes out. Phillips driving into the paint, looks left hand, doesn't go. Loose ball underneath, pulled down by Keontae Vernon.
They didn't walk out the smaller Vaughn, but to put a body on him, he's an athletic player.
Dreher back. Rule pulling down. Here comes Adu. Off the mark, pulled down by Freyer. Fresh 30 on the shot clock. Inside to Martin, down low, Keontae Vernon. Oh, too heavy, off the glass.
I thought Keontae could have just went up straight on the same side, that left side of the rim with a little more power. Trying to get a little fancy with the reverse layup and missed it. Leave a screen underneath on Henry.
Hey, Henry. See that press. Freyer up high, up off the glass. On Freyer.
I like the fact they got Fifi Adu to the middle and he looked opposite wing, and Freyer tried to take it hard to the hole, but nice job defensively stepping up and taking that charge squarely in the chest.
Was Vaughn. Yeah. Ball for the fouls, Darryl Riley.
Yeah, another one where they try a little DHO dribble handoff and can't pick off the defensive player like that while you're still moving with the basketball, and that was an easy call for the officials. Here they come back in that half-court trap again, trying to slow down this GCU and Lopes attack.
Martin back out, Freyer. Dirty, cross court, they do. Vernon play catch. Adu comes back out, Freyer to his right. Quick ball movement. Russell, three-point attempt, rings out. Still looking for a first bucket. Riley. Threaded through the paint, back out. Phillips, ooh, almost picked off, but Searles is in. Three-point attempt, and the Delta Devils get the first bucket.
Yeah, one of those classic examples. You go for the steal. If you don't come up with it, you get burned to give up an easy open opportunity.
Stopping and popping and dropping. Russell.
That's where Russell likes to live, to get his game going early on, getting that painted area. And he loves taking that ball from the left side of the floor to the right for that little floater or an opportunity at the rim.
Phillips. Vaughn. Quick ball movement. Searles looking for three and he connects.
A couple long balls here by the Delta Devils, give an easy, an early 6-2 advantage, and they go right back into that three-quarter press.
Russell, Freyer, he looks for three. Too heavy.
Well, if they continue to shoot these outside shots against this press, they're playing into the Devils' hands. They don't want you taking the ball inside. They're a very diminutive team. They don't want you to go downstairs and start banging them down low. Ekonke, Vernon, Freyer start posting up. Even Martin can post up.
Henry shot off the mark. Freyer, down low. Back out front, Russell stops, pulls down. Adu, good!
Fifi Adu likes that corner three, especially the right corner. Likes shooting along the baseline. Pulling up for that easy, looks like a long free throw if he has enough time to get his feet set. Somebody got out of position there in that zone, not communicating there defensively, verbally. Two guys on the ball is never a good thing when you're playing zone defense.
6-5 the score. The Delta Devils out on top. Andre Payne, boy, did he get it in the face of Tajay Henry after that. As Adu got that three off uncontested, as you look at Andre Payne in his third season as head coach of the Delta Devils. A year ago, the Lopes defeated Mississippi Valley State 94-60 back in late November. Josh Braun at 22. Dwayne Russell a double-double in the game, 11 points and 12 assists. As you look at DC, Darian Clark is going to be out a couple of weeks with that shoulder separation, and hopefully he'll come back. Had that problem at USC, had surgery. Looks like that might be on the horizon, and perhaps after the season.
Yeah, I know all too well about shoulders. I had both mine opened up. I had played through my senior year with a really bad right shoulder. I used to dislocate in a lot of basketball games for me. It's a pain, one of the most painful injuries I think I ever suffered during my basketball career is the shoulders, especially as a big when you have to do so much over your head.
Whoop. Out goes Riley.
timeout on the floor.
Timeout on the floor, 15:58 to go, opening half. In a one-point lead for Mississippi Valley State. We'll step aside, remain right here.
Founded on the belief that the entrepreneurial dream is an engine that drives innovation forward in a global marketplace, the Colangelo College of Business educates and develops values-driven business leaders. Our graduates exemplify the principles of servant leadership and entrepreneurship. GCU's strong Christian identity informs the education you receive, integrating our Christian values with the business curriculum. The college features more than 25 programs from the bachelor through the master's level, catering to traditional, evening, and online students. These programs serve a diverse set of aspiring business professionals who not only learn in the classroom, but gain real-world experience operating actual businesses. Our students also receive unique access to Jerry Colangelo's legendary experience, leadership, and connections throughout the business world. Find out more at gcu.edu/business.
I am Laura Lozoya, and I am majoring in biology with an emphasis in pre-med at Grand Canyon University. The dorm life at GCU definitely helped me build relationships, and I've made great friends on this campus. The quality education here is great. You're testing your limits, but you're going beyond them. It all comes together, the sciences, the ethics, and just everything. It's a beautiful thing.
Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back to GCU Arena, where you're watching Lopes basketball here on 3TV. GCU down early, 6-5 to Mississippi Valley State University, but it's still early, plenty to go. 16 minutes here in the first half. I'm Kate Longworth. Thank you so much for joining us. And we know the Lopes, well, they want the W tonight and in these next five non-conference games. However, the goal overall this year is to take care of the WAC. They want that conference title in this last year of transition in Division I play. And here's how the WAC conference shaping up right now. New Mexico State at 9-2. Right now, they are in action here in Phoenix over at ASU. They have the lead 45-38, but we're keeping a close eye on that. Meanwhile, CSU Bakersfield at 8-4. They have won their last three. UMKC lost their last one, but they still are at 7-5. Utah Valley at 5-4. Seattle University 6-5. And at the 500 mark, Grand Canyon University. So these wins at home, guys, we know how important they could be to Dan Marley. They've been playing some powerhouses and getting a lot of praise, but now you want to look at those numbers and build up that win column.
Martin back to Russell. To his right, Frayer. That's what he do. Russell now to Frayer. At his left, goes right. Payne driving up high, swatted away by Searles.
Well, that was a nice drive by Russell. Searles really did elevate there to get Russell's shot there. You can see he's so good, but coming out of that low block position, able to get a paw on it, and only five to shoot now for the low. Coach Payne is animated. He's the sixth man on defense over there.
Underneath, Adu, up high, doesn't fall.
Yeah, tough break so far. Looks cold from the field, just 2 of 8 shooting.
Riley, Searle. Back out front, the Delta Devils, three-point attempt. Off the mark, pulled down by Keontae Vernon.
Ooh. Keontae Vernon stepped on Dwayne Russell's foot.
Almost picked off, Adu. Underneath, Frayer for three. Good! Lopes take the lead.
Well, that's the kind of ball movement you need against that zone. Sometimes that skip pass is the best thing. A ball's gonna move faster than a man, and when you skip one rotation there, when they try to rotate in that zone, it's hard for them to recover.
bucket. Three-pointer by the Delta Devils. That's where they've hit every. Bounce pass inside. Keontae Vernon off the glass and in.
Now they're getting a better handle on how to attack that half-court zone defense and the full-court zone defense. They just are cookie-cutting that thing, and you can get a layup off of that. We get them up out of that trap real quick.
Searles pulls back over to his left, Riley. Gibbon looking for to provide some help there.
That's going to be Keontae Vernon. They're trying to hedge on that screen, but look at this one more time here. Nice penetration by Adu, kicking that thing out to the left there. Then one more time here, Keontae Vernon, strong to the hole. Plays that one up off glass with the power layup. Lopes back on top.
Frayer got a hand on it. It belonged to the Delta Devils.
Well, I love deflections, and I like that one a little bit better. Here, Frayer had to go for a steal early in the game and whiffed wildly on it and led to an open three. But when you can get yourself in that passing lane but still remain some sort of defensive balance while getting your hand on the ball, that's a good disruption.
Ooh. Russell almost got a hand on it, knocked it out. Belongs to the Lopes, went off of Riley's hands. He's
Five turnovers now for the Devils. They're going to get Riley out of this game. The young freshman, a little shaky with the basketball early on.
Phillips in for Riley. Russell brings it up. Plays catch with Fifi. Moves to his right. Now Frayer. Russell back out, making a decision where he's going to go. Martin quickly down and out. Kerwin Smith in, but Russell decides to take it himself for 3 points.
Yeah, he didn't get any penetration with the pass or the dribble to the middle of that, against the middle of that set this time, defensive set. So Russell decided to take the lid off the top of that defense, shoot right over the top.
Searles turns, loses the handle. Kerwin Smith there. Foul called on Jamal Watson.
Yeah, see, this is just one where I'm just going to call my own number, or just a one little dribble forward. Notice he got the defender backing up. Then he rises right up over to the top of the defense and knocks it down. So nice job by Dwayne Russell, really bailing out the GCU Lopes offense on that possession.
Third foul on the Delta Devils. Russell, some help from Smith, down to Adu. Too heavy, rebound pulled down by Isaac Williams.
If we can get a whack play, Adu's gonna learn to be able to show that shot, but also be able to drive that ball hard to the middle and see if he can't create something for himself or one of his teammates underneath.
Williams inside underneath Gibbon and puts it home.
That was a really nice feed. Martin's down there fronting that low block and takes a nice touch to be able to find this offensive player and not let the weak side defense get their time to swat that ball away.
Adu, Frayer, three-point attempt. Off the mark to the left, Kerwin Smith battling underneath.
I think they're gonna get Watson.
Yeah.
Watson and Smith were battling down there. Watson seemed the tough one, Bridget. Don't think he wanted a foul, but he lost his balance when he was coming down from his leap and got tangled underneath with Kerwin Smith, who did a nice job going up to that offensive board with two hands.
So Watson takes a seat to Jay Henry back in. Kerwin being pressured, picked off by Searles.
You could see that turnover about to happen. You don't want Smith having that coffin corner down there with the huge dribble trying to find an offensive player, a teammate to pass that ball to.
Williams up high. Oh, tapped it back over Shaq Carr.
Offensive play by Isaac Williams. He was, but we thought we had him in the starting lineup. They went with the smaller Riley, but Williams making his presence felt off that bench quickly.
Oh, hey, Dwayne Russell.
Dwayne Russell now with two quick three-point shots in this basketball game. You can see they playing that zone defense to keep Russell out of that middle. And he's knocking down those outside shots. I don't know how much longer Coach Payne will be able to stay with that zone defense principle.
Picked off by Jared Martin, taking it to the bucket, drops it in.
Well, Martin's another one of these players loves to play in the passing lane. The Devils right now just turned the basketball over at a far too great rate.
Searles, eyed by Frayer.
bounce pass. Henry, back out Gibbon. Gibbon to his right, finds Searles. Searles trying to drive on Freyer. Freyer's gonna be called for the foul.
Freyer got up on him a little too tight, maybe just a foot too close there. You know, you don't want to take away that outside shot, but you don't want to put the ball on the floor and then get called for a cheapy foul.
Freyer's second personal foul, timeout on the floor. 5-point Lopes lead over the Delta Devils here on 3TV.
GCU offers more than 200 innovative programs across 9 colleges, which now include cutting-edge next-generation programs in engineering, computer science, and information technology. Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu. Christmas from Grand Canyon University.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
Welcome back to GCU Arena. You're watching Lopes basketball here on 3TV. GCU right now with the 18-13 lead over the Delta Devils. I'm Kate Longworth. Well, Dan Marley's message to his team is simple. He wants them to go out there, obviously get the W, but he wants them to go out there and establish the tone, get momentum on their side. We've seen them do that against powerhouses such as Louisville, San Diego State, Arizona. They've gone out there and been very competitive. However, sometimes at home, and this can happen with any good team, it can be hard to get that momentum going if the team you are playing isn't as strong as some of those ones with the big names and headlines. So, Scott, I kind of have a question for you as a player. When you would go up against some of those schools that maybe didn't have that hype surrounding it, the crowd not as into it, those types of things, when you're going up against a team like this looking for that first win, and they can be dangerous, how do you not overlook an opponent? How do you set the tone?
You know, that's a young player's trap, unfortunately, is human nature. But as an experienced player, and they'll look to the juniors and seniors on this team to provide that kind of a mindset that you won't look past an opponent, that you'll be ready to play.
Inbound for the Delta Devil. Dreiler. Oh, got it. Caught up in his shoelaces there. Long range shot off the mark. Irwin Smith able to pull that down over two Delta Devils. Russell on the run. Russell to his left. Finds Shaq, pushes it back underneath. Foul underneath. Williams called.
Well, he gets a strong rebound. Kerwin Smith uses those live legs to transition to be able to run the floor and lost that ball. It kind of went, it went through the basket from the bottom. It came back down. Not quite sure why they're only giving him one shot. Are they saying that that bucket counted? I'm a little confused here. I think the officials are too.
It's 20 on the.
Yeah, two shots. The ball, what happened was after he got fouled, the ball went through the cylinder from the bottom up and then came back down. And I think one of the officials that didn't call the foul thought possibly that it was a three-point opportunity for Kerwin Smith. Let's take a look at it one more time and see Shaq Carr with a nice dish. And Kerwin Smith gets hacked right there. The ball goes up through the basket.
It comes back
from the bottom and comes down. And the officials thought that he had made the play. Well, anyway, instead of a three-point opportunity, he ends up with one. Yeah. Anyway, Lopes lead 19-13.
Driving, oh, swatted away by Martin. Boy, his defensive prowess definitely hasn't dropped off. Martin, no look. Russell, he pulled down. He had a quick second there before Delta Devils came out. Vaughn, Carr inside. Throwing Smith, Carr. Whoop. Loses a handle, push back, got a little sloppy. Carr driving, push out, Martin off the glass, and an easy put back.
Well, getting good looks, shooting a high percentage right now.
Riley. Back out, quickly Phillips looking to his left. Saw that ball come to his right. Vaughn, bounce pass, Searles, 10 on the shot clock. Phillips, Williams, Searles, three, turnaround.
The two guys leave the man with the basketball and go to the weak side. They didn't want to give up the three-pointer, but they gave up an easy look from just outside the free throw line.
Russell gets through it, takes the feed back, leaves it, oh, behind Keontae. Definitely not a crisp game here. Keontae, turnaround short. Goodness gracious. Keontae Vernon called.
Guy went up for a jump shot, got called for an offensive foul. That's a little bit weak sauce right there by the officiating crew. He's grown men here. Let him play a little bit more basketball than that, a little more contact. And I think it was a great pass there by Martin. Go back to this one more time. Martin with a nice little shovel. And that's pretty much just going straight up for a shot. If anything, I think it was the defender that banged into Keontae Martin. Or excuse me, yeah, Keontae Vernon.
Vaughn, I'd buy Carolyn Smith. Oh, if you do, got it. Back out Phillips, 8-7. He's a long way from the bucket. 5-4. Trying to move, stopping, popping up over Carr, short. Rebound up, Martin off of his hands. It'll belong to Mississippi Valley State.
Yeah, give Gibbons a lot of credit for that one. He's the one that kind of fought after the basketball for Martin and made it so it wasn't a clean opportunity for a rebound for him. Just the second offensive rebound here for the Devils here in this first half.
Williams, Phillips now. Riley trying to move on Russell up over the top. Goodness gracious. Russell called.
Let's see what Dwayne Russell is supposed to do here defensively. I think he does a pretty good job moving his feet, playing without fouling. And as Riley took the ball right through Russell's chest, I thought that was some pretty strong defense by Riley. And I believe the officials are, they have the right to miss a call every now and again, too.
Really? All right.
You don't want them to, but unfortunately it happens.
I guess they're human beings. Martin up over Riley, takes it back from Carr. Look out, being swarmed quickly up to Russell. They don't make it easy to the Delta Devils.
Oh, they like that. After made baskets and free throws, they like putting that pressure on.
You know who's enjoyable to watch on the sideline? It is their coach Payne over there.
Oh, yeah.
Man, he gets into the game.
Yes, he is. I think he's ratcheting up his belt there. Yeah. And he's down in a defensive stance. Half the time he's working the sidelines. He's already got the perspiration. He's got his jacket. He's got the perspiration coming out from underneath the dress shirt. He's working hard. He wants his victory. You start 0-10, you're going to do everything you can to try to get in that win column.
I don't care what sport it is. I don't like to see a coach sitting on his rear end.
I agree.
Just get into the game. Turnaround, Vaughn. Foul in the Delta Devils. Basha Vaughn called for the foul on the Delta Devils. The lead is 4. 7:45 to go. Opening half. We'll be back as the Lopes begin the first of 4 on their home court. Trying to win their 6th of the season here on 3TV.
My company's Comfortpedic Inc. We're a local mattress company here. It's a small family business that my dad started. Now we are providing the dorm mattresses to the most recent dorms here at GCU. One of my professors, he was a professor for my junior year, Paul Waterman, he was the one that started everything. Without him, like, this wouldn't have been possible. I came up with a short presentation, a quick business pitch. I present to Dr. Gibb with my company history, and he loved it. So first we started with the hotel mattresses. Brett Courtwhite was very helpful, and everything ran smoothly. From there, we began with the dorm mattresses. We asked them what exactly they were looking for in a dorm mattress, and that's when we started to come up with a prototype. We brought in one of the mattresses that GCU currently has. We opened it up. We saw where they needed improvement and what we could do best to, like, maximize a better prototype, and we came up with the mattresses that we have now, and after that everything ran pretty smoothly, thankfully. You can see the community thriving along with GCU, and just the fact that GCU was willing to buy locally from a company that's only 10 minutes away, you can tell that they really want the community to grow with them. I'm very proud to say I'm a Lope, and I tell it to everyone, like, go to GCU, Lopes up. I'm very, very proud.
Here on 3TV right now, GCU on top of Mississippi Valley State University 21-17. I'm Kate Longworth. Well, right now behind me in action is the student section. The Havocs are in the house tonight. However, it is the holiday break, so this is a good time if you're at home with the family to try to get the family out here. You can try and keep up with the student section, but also bring in your own noise. The GCU team has a lot of games coming up starting this Tuesday, the 20th. You can also head out here on the 22nd against the University of Arkansas Pine Bluff. You'll see the team. Then they'll take a quick timeout for Christmas and Christmas Eve, returning to the court here at GCU on the 28th against Cal Poly. All of those are 7 p.m. tip-offs. Tickets still available. You can check out the GCU box office or online. And guys, Scott Berry, you know what an atmosphere this is. There's dancing fans. We got Thunder here. It's a great experience. The students right now getting a lot of accolades as they go up against the likes of Louisville and Arizona, with Patino and Miller complimenting the student section. But really, there's a lot of kids in attendance here, a lot of families. And when you're on the holiday break, and sometimes it gets a little hard with those kids at home wondering what to do, well, hey, bring them out here for a game.
No doubt about it. Great experience. Jack Carr.
Ooh, he got a little shove there.
How did he miss that?
I have no idea that he drove him down. Oh, no bucket.
Jared Martin giving up his body on the defensive end once again, taking a charge. And I don't know how Shaq Carr got knocked out of the air. It went no call whatsoever. We've seen less contact sometimes on plays on the floor than we did in this one in midair.
His left hand.
That young man could have been injured on that play.
Russell being swarmed by the Delta Devils, gets it up to Shaq Carr. Fifi. Off the wing. Back out, Carr. Carr driving to his left. Goes up high, underhand with his right, and he dropped it in.
That's the way you beat a zone defense there. You catch that basketball when the defense is in rotation, you drive it hard to the rack.
Riley inside. Vaughn turning on Martin. Back out. Phillips leaves. For Riley, bounce pass inside. Gibbon stopping, turning, and up over the top of Kerwin Smith.
How about that by Gibbons? That was nice little one dribble to the baseline. Caught Kerwin Smith backing up and then rolls right up over the top of the long arm. High jumping Smith.
Carr inside, Kerwin Smith doesn't go. Draw the foul though. Did Kerwin. On Vasha Vaughn.
That was a nice job by Kerwin Smith using his left hand there against a smaller defender. But the lady behind me screams, "You gotta dunk it." And I kind of agree with her, but you don't want the offensive foul. But Kerwin Smith did a good job using his offhand, drawing the contact and going to the line. And that one there by Gibbons was a thing of beauty. Kerwin Smith wanted a little payback at the other end when he got it down low and in that painted area. Now this is where Smith's got to improve. He's got to start making some free throws.
Right. Conley leads it over there for Searles. Searles has a couple of threes. Back over to Phillips. Phillips to his left. He finds Riley. Riley threads the needle, stops. Rebound, battled after by Smith and by Jared Martin. Martin up for Russell.
You like to see two white jerseys with four hands on that basketball.
In the corner is Adu, back out, Martin. Down into the corner again, Adu pushes back out, Martin. Finds Carr, now he goes the opposite side. Three-point attempt, not there. Kerwin Smith trying to get a hand on it, got behind him. Running up is Riley with a nice bucket underneath.
Darryl. Darryl. He had a little respite, so he tracked that basketball down. He knew he was going to the bucket. He put a little spin on that ball off the glass, and it fell right through nicely.
Fifi back out, Martin. He'll try the three. Connects! Hey,
hey, hey! That's a nice play right there. That skip pass once again, moving that basketball from the left side to the right side. Looked like Martin had a little fake pass down to that right corner where they've been going with success. Left him open on the top.
Vaughn hands it over to Phillips. Phillips to Searles. Rashawn Searles. Kerwin Smith.
I see that Martin three again. This young man's been kind of struggling behind the arc. But see that skip pass? Then that fake pass down to the right just froze number five Searles long enough for Martin to get a good clean look at the bucket.
Strother Jr. in the game for the Delta Devils. Underneath around Shaq Carr is Phillips.
Yeah, he did a nice job really funneling his man to the baseline help, but all of a sudden two guys left the basketball. We've seen that twice tonight.
Martin down low, Shaq Carr bounce pass, Martin all the way across over to Fifi driving baseline.
That's the play I was saying that Fifi Adu is going to learn. He'll learn later in the season, catching that basketball, showing that shot from the outside, and taking it hard to the hole. Gets the defense in such rotation. If you're able to drive the basketball at them while they're moving out towards you, they're at a huge disadvantage.
75% free throw shooter, Fifi Adu connects. Ronald Strother Jr., fresh into the game, called for the foul. The sophomore from Birmingham, Alabama. Lead is six. Riley bringing it up. Freshman from Milwaukee. Hands it over to Amos Gibbon. Searles back to Gibbon. Shot off the mark. Russell pulled back after attempting to grab after it, but it went out of bounds.
Yeah, that's why you're always a little confused. Did one of my guys get a fingertip on it? Should I grab this ball, or is that just an air ball? I don't want to risk not getting it cleanly and having it drop on the baseline and giving the ball back to the Devils. But right now, this Delta Devils defense of full court pressure is having zero effect on the Lopes after it was successful in the first 5 minutes of the basketball game. Now they're just cutting right through like a hot knife through butter, getting just about anything they want on the offensive end.
Give it his first personal foul.
You wonder if Coach Green is not going to throw a little man-to-man after one of these timeout breaks, or maybe come back in the second half with some man-to-man defense, try to give the Lopes a different look, because right now what they're doing in that three quarters and half court trap isn't working.
Lead is eight. Riley eyed by Russell. Bounce pass. Brother Jr. back out. Isaac Williams back over to Riley. Riley finds Searles, and Searles runs right into Jared Martin. Martin called. What can
he trying to do?
I don't know. I'm sitting here watching the game of basketball. Sometimes I get so confused at how the game is called, because if I'm Jared Martin, I have to say to myself, I'm able to stand in a position. If they run me over, it's not a foul on me. And I think sometimes nowadays in the game of basketball, the offensive player gets too much liberties in the defense. It makes it too hard to play defense without fouling. You only see a ton of whistles, and that's not enjoyable for anybody, players or fans.
Carr down in the corner, driving the baseline. Oh, sweet move. Put back Kerwin Smith.
Oh, nice job by Kerwin Smith, using those long legs, following his teammate up. Oh, that was a travel that got away with one there.
Timeout on the floor, 33-23, 10-point lead by the Lopes over the Delta Devils from Mississippi Valley State. Kerwin Smith, no doubt about it.
GCU is the university that never sleeps, moving at the speed of light. And now GCU is leading in the area of computer science and IT. With over 200 university degree programs across 9 colleges, on campus and online, join the most inventive concept in education today. Fast track options available with courses in cybersecurity, cloud computing, and systems architecture. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/IT. At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty and student advisors. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692.
Finding the right college isn't always simple. The choices I make today affect where I'll be tomorrow. That's why I chose Grand Canyon University. Here I'm working toward a greater purpose and a place that feels like home. With scholarships to help me earn my degree, I can graduate in less than 4 years. By attending GCU, Arizona's premier private Christian university, I know I'm not just making the right choice, I'm making the smart choice.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back. We're talking GCU's walking wounded. Josh Braun had his knee scoped just 2 weeks ago. He's off crutches now, working his way back with physical therapy and strength exercises. He hopes to be back for WAC conference play. Meanwhile, Darian Clark dislocated his shoulder earlier this week against the Wildcats. Director of Sports Gordy told me that Jordy told me that his goal here is to get him back in 2 weeks. And it's a tough order because Darian did have shoulder surgery earlier in his career, so that may be the outcome after this season. But again, trying to get him back 2 weeks on the court here with the Lopes. And guys, I've been told from the Lopes, what you see is what you get. Because as you see, more guys in street clothes than the purple uniform. Not good.
No. Too many hoodies over there on that baseline.
They're good looking hoodies, I'll tell you that. But.
Yeah, how do I get my hands on one of those 3XLT?
Those are easy to find.
That'd be the team shop, right?
Yeah. Jordy Hackett is definitely getting
he's earning his paycheck this year, isn't he?
Right?
Does he get a bonus, like, gets these guys back sooner? Maybe that's what we need to motivate him and these players to get back on the court. We need these guys by playing that far away.
We're getting ready, hopefully. At least Josh Braun, they're in ready for conference play in early January. Team's definitely on the rise. Utah Valley will be that first matchup.
Searles turns, twists. Oh, how about Rashad Searles, the senior point guard from Flossmoor, Illinois.
Give that man 2.5 points for that one. That was wonderful move in the interior against that Lopes defense.
Russell back over to his left. Martin off the mark.
Saw that.
3 minute mark.
It looks like Martin's left hand gets involved in his shot at times. He's got generally a pretty good stroke, but at times it seems like that left hand's getting involved in that shot. He's pulling it sideways.
Searles to his left, handed it over to Williams. Williams, Phillips now back out front to his left. Driving and losing it is Watson, but into the hands of Strother Jr. off the glass and in.
Oh, wow.
They're hitting a couple of buckets.
Yeah, getting inside for a couple buckets. Weren't buying anything on the outside.
We're 9 of 18 shooting coming out of that commercial break, and they get a couple of easy buckets inside.
Up high, current Smith! Bam!
Oh, that was nice. I think I can get a little credit over there, that GCU coaching staff there. That was the high handoff. Coach Marley likes to draw coming out of timeouts, and Dwayne Russell threw a perfect strike to Curlin Smith.
Charles knocking it on Carr. Moving to his left, didn't have anything. Takes it back. Quick ball moving. Phillips, 9-8 on the shot clock, trying to move on Martin. Stops, pops. In, out, pulled down by Curlin Smith. Smith getting some extended minutes here, opening half with Keontae Vernon on the bench. Down to the corner, back out. Fifi pulls down. Martin into the paint. Goes right in, and he's fouled.
Nice drive that time by Martin, but this is the other one I love. He did so much attention paid to Dwayne Russell. He's able to get in that painted area, and you got Smith just so long, so athletic, sneaking behind the back line of that defense for the high handoff, and he put it to bed.
Connects. 9 of 18 coming in. 50%.
From the free throw line?
Yeah.
Oh, I wouldn't believe that. If you told me that, I'd bet you $5 you were wrong on that one, because he's got a good free throw stroke, but he doesn't get to the line enough for me. I think sometimes when he's struggling with the shot, that should be his sanctuary, getting to that free throw line so he can work on his form at the arc. See, he keeps that left hand way behind that basketball. Not way behind it, but off to the side of it on that free throw, and sometimes that'll help you. Now when you go into your floor shot, you got defenders whizzing at you and you're on the move, then you can remember that same stroke that you just did and just repeat it from the line, from the field.
Searles, right by Carr, 120 and counting, opening half. Searles looking to make a move, loses the handle. Strother Jr. off the mark, pulled down by Carr. Shaq brings it up. Down in the corner. Fifi back out. Russell quickly to Carr. 1 minute left to go, opening half.
Shaq Carr wanted that pass to Fifi back. He just threw in a bad spot where Fifi couldn't do anything with it once he caught it.
Russell drives, takes it behind his back. Driving in the paint, up high, pushed out. Martin looks for three. Short. Rebound kicked out. Fifi tried to swat it. Picked up by Strother Jr.
I like a couple guys go fighting for that basketball. Go slamming it into the bench. Now Delta Devils want to try to play for the last shot. It's about a 7 second differential between shot clock and game clock here.
Talon Phillips from Memphis, Tennessee. Patiently. Moving now with 10. Williams, Searles, 7-6, Searles. Pushes back out. Oh, Russell almost got a hand on it. Phillips, short. Martin's there. Six, quickly, Russell. Did the Lopes get the last bucket of the half? Russell drives and it drops. Oh, I thought he was going to get the hoop in the arm.
Oh, that's how you play it out there. You get that stop, get that rebound, and then you're off to the races with mighty Dwayne Russell driving that basketball right down the Delta defense and for the layup.
41-27 halftime score. Let's send it over to Kate Longworth with Coach Marley.
All right, thank you guys. Well, Coach, you guys are shooting nearly 50%, very strong from beyond the arc. What's working for the team so far?
I don't know. We're not doing a really good job. They're shooting 50% from the floor, probably even better than that. We're doing a bad job. We're not being aggressive. Got into foul trouble early with Oscar and Keontae, which we can't do. We just got to do a better job on this and handling the pressure, be more aggressive.
What's the message to the team when you are going against an opponent that can be dangerous? They haven't picked up their first win and they're applying the pressure. So what do you want to say to your team at halftime to keep up the intensity?
Well, I tell them we're not very good either, so we got to go out and play. I mean, that's just the way it is. If we don't play well, we don't play hard, you know, we'll lose the game. You know, these guys are going to play hard. They cause a lot of havoc with their press, their changing defense. So we got to be aggressive and, you know, we got to go on a little bit of a roll.
All right, thank you. Best of luck in the second half. Some honest words from Dan Marley. Guys, we know he sets the standard high, and I think you're seeing a little of that frustration, wanting his team near perfect in the second half, that's for sure.
Yep, 14-point lead, not good enough for Coach Marley over the Delta Devils from Mississippi Valley State. More of our halftime festivities continue. Kate will be back in just a moment. As the Lopes lead at half over Mississippi Valley State.
Taylor. I'm a senior here at GCU, and I'm studying marketing.
Moving on campus is one of the best decisions ever. Being an RA has given me a lot of experience that I think I can carry on through the rest of my life.
Throughout my time here at GCU, I've needed $20,000 worth of assistance, but through my on-campus position and the multiple scholarships, I've been able to earn the money each year to pay that back, so by the time I walk across the stage, I'll have no debt.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
It's that time again. Time to be thankful. Time to be with loved ones. A full calendar and a full plate. Family Christmas and family traditions. The years go by fast. And the holidays, even faster. Now's the time to make room for what's really important. Giving back and going forward. Building memories and creating a better future. This is your season. Seize it. GCU's online degree program puts you first, so you can make the most of your time. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. GCU.edu.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over 3 decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692.
Welcome back, a live look in GCU Arena right now, where the halftime show is taking place as the Lopes head into the locker room with a 14-point lead over Mississippi Valley State University. Although Coach Marley demanding more from his team in the second half, so we'll see how it all plays out. I'm Kate Longworth. You're watching college basketball here on Free TV, and I'm joined now by some GCU Olympic athletes. Jade Howard, who qualified for Rio in swimming, she's from Zambia, and Tara Sue Barnett with the track and field team here. She was representing her country of Jamaica. Guys, congratulations. What a summer it must have been for you. I mean, how do you put into words what it's like to be an Olympian?
I mean, the whole experience was just so incredible, and being able to be there and represent my country was just such an amazing experience.
And how did you qualify for your country?
I qualified at a meet in Irvine, California. It was like the third meet before WAGIT competition, and time was winding down, and I was very excited that I qualified.
What was your favorite parts of the Rio experience?
I would say for me, my favorite part was the opening ceremony. Just walking out and having the whole crowd cheer for you and walking behind the Zambian flag was just really fun.
And for you?
My favorite part of the Olympics was going out to compete against world-class athletes and knowing that I've become one of them also.
And for you, you got to bring Coach Schaefer, who's a coach for you here at school, along with you. What was that experience like to share that with him?
It was so great to have Coach Schaefer with me. Obviously, I'd worked with him for a long time, so I just felt comfortable, and he was able to calm my nerves. And to have a familiar face on such a big stage was really helpful for me.
And the track season is just around the corner. What are you anticipating for the new season?
Well, I'm working on qualifying for the World Championship, and that would be great if I could go there and make a final this time.
Setting the bar high, I like that. Well, congratulations, guys. It's an honor to talk to you ladies after qualifying for the Olympics and a wonderful experience. We wish you the best of luck in your careers here at GCU and in world competitions, too. All right, thank you so much for joining us here on the GCU Halftime Show. More Lopes Halftime Show coming your way here on 3TV. We'll be right back with highlights, stats, and much, much more right after this.
Christmas from Grand Canyon University.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
It's that time again. Time to be thankful. Time to be with loved ones. A full calendar and a full plate. Family Christmas and family traditions. The years go by fast. And the holidays, even faster. Now's the time to make room for what's really important. Giving back and going forward. Building memories and creating a better future. This is your season. Seize it. GCU's online degree program puts you first, so you can make the most of your time. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. GCU.edu.
Back live at GCU Arena on the campus of Grand Canyon University on a chilly evening for those that live in the Phoenix area. 41-27 is the halftime score with the Lopes on top of the Delta Devils. Well, Coach Marley talked to Kate Longworth at halftime. He wasn't pleased. These are the type of games that, well, you've got to kind of work on some things when you take on maybe a higher caliber opponent, especially when conference play starts.
Yeah, the Thunder Dan came out and Coach Marley there. He was not happy whatsoever. Wanted his guys to knuckle up on defense, play a little better defense, let the Devils shoot 48% in that first half. Turned them over nine times, and it led to 11 points, but he wants an even better a first half. He wants these guys clicking on all cylinders, and I think some of those early fouls frustrate him when his bigs get into foul trouble.
Let's take a look at our halftime highlights. Began with Rashawn Searles, hit 2 of 3 from the arc.
Yeah, Searles was absolutely fantastic. He had two of their three-point shots. It was a three-point party to kind of start this one. I love that assist by Russell, kicking it over to Dew in the corner. He knocks down a three, and then he says, okay, I give, and then I'll take. He knocks down his own three of his own there, and then this one by Mark gets a steal, puts in transition. I like to see him finish that overhand there with the slam dunk, but lays it in there. Always so good defensively. Shaq Carr with knifing right down there, right to the hole. Nice job by the Shaq attack. I love that one there by Riley. He had 7 points in that first half. One of a swift little layup there, and then where is Kerwin Smith? Right there on that glass. Gets the offensive rebound, put back in. 6 points and 5 rebounds. Searles again, cut through there with a sniffy move. The high handoff to Smith was a thing of beauty. And then here to beat the final buzzer of the half there, Russell Hart to the hole. Probably got some contact on that one, but they take that right to the locker room with them in 14-point lead.
You mentioned 11 points off of those 9 turnovers. 6 steals by the Lopes, 1 for the Delta Devils. The lead is 14 at the half. Second half, boy, Kate mentioned during the halftime that Coach Marley really laid into Jared Martin there at the end of the half before they had an opportunity to speak. So this is really an opportunity for guys like Jared Martin. He obviously played every minute of that opening half. He's got to really step up his game now that the bench is a little bit tighter. Guys like that that are starters need to really pour it on.
Well, we saw Oscar Frere have a slow first half at the U of A, came back, had a strong second half. I think some guys need to take the lead from his example there and then come out here and play a little better in the second half, because you know Coach Marley, he's got his whip out there in that locker room.
All right, we'll be back with more of our halftime festivities from GCU Arena. As I mentioned, the Lopes up by 14 over the Delta Devils. Leave it here on 3TV.
I'm Taylor. I'm a senior here at GCU, and I'm studying marketing. Moving on campus is one of the best decisions ever. Being an RA has given me a lot of experience that I think I can carry on through the rest of my life. Throughout my time here at GCU, I've needed $20,000 worth of assistance, but through my on-campus position and the multiple scholarships, I've been able to earn the money each year to pay that back, so by the time I walk across the stage, I'll have no debt.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
It's that time again. Time to be thankful. Time to be with loved ones. A full calendar and a full plate. Family Christmas and family traditions. The years go by fast. And the holidays, even faster. Now's the time to make room for what's really important. Giving back and going forward. Building memories and creating a better future. This is your season. Seize it. GCU's online degree program puts you first, so you can make the most of your time. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. GCU.edu.
At GCU, earning your degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. To find your purpose, it takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over three decades of experience in delivering real-world degree programs online. GCU's online class size averages less than 17 students with full-time faculty. Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Call us today at 855-428-7692.
Welcome back to GCU Arena. You're watching Lopes Basketball here on 3TV. Dan Marley's Lopes with a 14-point lead at the break over the Delta Devils. However, Dan Marley demanding more from his team. I just spoke to him moments ago at halftime, and he said they need to be more aggressive out there and set the tone. He doesn't like to see the Devils with so many points on the board right now. Searles leading the way for the Mississippi Valley State right now with 10. Dwayne Russell also has 10 points for the Lopes. Martin with 9, Adu with 9, and Kerwin Smith with 6. We have plenty of more second half action coming your way. Dan Marley said he had a strong message at the half. We'll see if message was received. Lopes basketball continues here on 3TV right after this.
Christmas from Grand Canyon University.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
It's that time again. Time to be thankful. Time to be with loved ones. A full calendar and a full plate. Family Christmas and family traditions. The years go by fast. And the holidays, even faster. Now's the time to make room for what's really important. Giving back and going forward. Building memories and creating a better future. This is your season. Seize it. GCU's online degree program puts you first, so you can make the most of your time. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. GCU.edu.
Barry Buttel, Scott Williams, Kate Longworth. Back at GCU Arena in Phoenix, Arizona, where the Lopes are up by 14. And we begin the second half. The fans will remain on their feet until the Lopes hit their opening bucket of the second stanza. Sean Searles, the leading scorer for the Delta Devils in the opening half, leaves it for Gibbon. Here's handed it back to Riley. Riley looked to his left for Searles. Guarded heavily. Riley takes it himself. Too heavy. Kick back out Russell.
Interesting to see that they stayed with that zone. Mix it up a little bit. It's more of a 1-2-2 traditional zone this time rather than that
that 3-2 that they were playing in the first half.
Eight on the shot clock. Freyer brings it in. Dishes out, picked off by Searles. Up high to Riley, up off the glass, and like they did the opening half, the Delta Devils get on the board first.
Yeah, they only turned it over, GC only turned it over four times that first half, but you got Oscar Fredman sitting on that bench a long time. Didn't come in ready, play offensively, coughed it up quickly there, first time he touched it.
Russell takes it back from Adu, moves to his left. And reach in, Riley.
Yeah, you turn the basketball over, you better get back defensively. You see Frere goes in there, tries to get that steal. Puts a lot of pressure on the back line of that defense. Martin just couldn't hold it down. Easy layup with it on the other end.
Third on Riley, got to be careful. Martin to his left. Steve Adu.
We got Fifi Adu for an offensive foul there. He couldn't get by. Who was that?
Phillips.
Yeah, Phillips did a good job moving his feet. And then you see that just that right arm there comes up. He got away with one in the first half. Actually got the benefit of the whistle, but that was an easy one for the officials to call. I want to try to drive that ball and be aggressive, but you have to have an in-between game. That's something that Russell has really developed here the last year and a half. We're able to pull up or find guys underneath or out on the perimeter.
Well, Henry leaves for Riley.
You know, Adu's done so much good here in the early half of this season that you forget he's just a freshman.
Yeah, you really do. Phillips to Henry. Henry wants Riley to move inside. Bounce pass given. Swarmed by Martin and Vernon. Picked off by Freyer, but it goes off and out of bounds.
Couldn't quite get it. Six there trying to go down and grab that one off the top of a shoe top. Just couldn't control the basketball. But I love that firing into the passing lane after you get a good solid trap. Always leads to positive actions.
In the corner, Phillips drains it.
Ooh, look out, Delta Devil. Phillips just 1 of 5 in that first half. And only doing a good job on the defensive end, and now he comes back and knocks down a three-point shot. How often do you see a guy make a good play on the defensive end and comes from positive, happens to him offensively?
Oh, Martin tried to go underneath. A lot of fouls. It's on Riley. Phillips.
First personal, second team foul.
This is this place where I think Mark could live. You know, you see Josh Braun when he's out there, he gets to the foul line quite a bit, and he's got an excellent stroke. And I think Martin's one of these players that could also get to the foul line a lot.
Martin connects. Perfect 4 for 4 for Jared Martin from the free throw line. Fans can take a seat. Riley. Give it, turning on Keontae. Underneath, Henry. Way back out. Ooh, just up beyond the extended hand of Russell. Riley giving it back to Given. Given trying to get up over the top. Rebound pulled down by Keontae Vernon. Hey, do.
Got Martin on the wing here.
Russell. Short, pushed out, Martin's chasing after, grabs it away from Riley. Fifi steps in, back out Martin. Russell, decide what to do. Had by Phillips. Oh, knocked out. Phillips, that's something.
Hey, Phillips got the worst of that foul. They didn't get Russell does a good job getting him in the air, and then that's the one where Russell's just got him in a bad position. He's going to take advantage of the fact that now I got you in the air. I'm just going right into your body, and I'm going to the line. I'm questions whether or not he's stepped on that three-point line or if he stayed behind. I think they just gave him the 2 free throws, but nice job by Russell there, which bailed him out of a offensive set to look more like a wreck game than anything else. There wasn't a whole lot going on there offensively. Offensive rebound, helter skelter. Finally, Russell just goes up and gets that foul and goes to the line. Oh, I take that back. They're giving him 3 shots from that line. See if he was behind that arc one more time. He Oh, yeah, clearly that right toe was a good 6-8 inches behind that Clark. Good call by the official right over it.
Hey. Perfect three from the line.
Phillips. Swirls down low, Riley. Soft little floater and it drops.
Impressive with this young freshman here in Milwaukee. He's coming here and done a nice job. Yep. Turned the ball over a couple times, but probably just nerves.
Freer for three!
Oh, Oscar Freer. He's a streaky three-point shooter, but he's been hot here in the month of December getting these balls to drop.
Zeros, that floater didn't go.
Yeah, on the glass, knocks the three down, goes back, gets the board. He's got himself engaged. Maybe he's a second-half player. Looking for 16 in the second half of that U of A game after going scoreless for the first half.
Martin fed Fifi underneath. Put enough on it.
Yeah, Fifi, you do. You know, he's not the highest jumper, but those arms are so quick, and he's got just so crafty and quick with the basketball. And long arms, gets it up off the glass.
Lopes opening up the lead now, 51-34 over the Delta Devils. 16-14 to go. Second half.
GCU offers more than 200 innovative programs across 9 colleges, which now include cutting-edge next-generation programs in engineering, computer science, and information technology. Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu. Christmas from Grand Canyon University.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State. Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
Back at GCU Arena, Lopes up in their lead here in the second half, 51-34. Now, WAC conference play starts in early January, and the teams are definitely improving. We see the final score by New Mexico State taking on the team located in Tempe, Arizona, with an 11-point victory tonight.
Well, the Sun Devils went down. I think the Lopes want to try to make the Delta Devils take a loss back to Mississippi with them.
Aaron shot up to Keontae Vernon. Quickly, all picked off. A little sloppy. Goes out of bounds. It'll inbound for GCU. Freyer back there. Timeout.
Timeout on the floor.
Let's send it over to Kate.
All right, guys, well, you know it was a big game against Arizona earlier this week. On the scoreboard, the Lopes fell short. However, with post-game remarks like this, I think you could say they scored big.
They're the hardest playing team we've played this season. And, you know, you start talking about Butler, who they are, Michigan State, who they are. Grand Canyon's they play hard. And they're very physical, and I'm sure that comes from Dan and, you know, how they're playing the game. But it was a great test. The other thing is, in my 8 years, I've never seen a section in McHale filled with the visitors. I mean, they had a whole section, and you could hear them cheering. And you just tell they got a great spirit about what they're doing.
Those are some glowing remarks regardless of who said it. But when it comes from a guy like Sean Miller, who obviously is the coach of a Pac-12 powerhouse like Arizona, and that can be an interstate rival for GCU obviously already is for ASU. You could just understand what kind of weight those words would come. You think that he is really praising Dan Marley and what that means to the program. And Scott, as a player, do words like that have an effect on you and your game? Because now this is becoming a trend. We heard it from Rick Pitino. We're hearing it from Sean Miller. They're getting national write-ups. Does this affect the Lopes? Can they, you know, hang their hat on this and really be proud? And could it affect their play?
Well, absolutely, Kate. I think what Coach Marley has built here is that his teams will play hard. And when you start getting that recognition from the Millers and the Pitinos of the coaching industry, it motivates the players to say, yeah, we are doing it right. Let's continue to do that. And I think after this transition period has ended this season, it's only going to help with recruiting. Hey, can't, you know, high school kids around the state of Arizona and around the country for that matters hear and see what is going on here at Grand Canyon University. They want to be a part of that.
Fifi Adu away from the ball, gets called for the foul. Second personal foul on Fifi. The coach likes to see that. Yeah, the Havocs traveled as they did to Duke.
Yes, they do. I tweeted about the Havocs going down to McHale, wondering how many people are going down there, told them to mount up and get on down the road. And sure enough, that is a nice compliment Coach Miller paid that student body section, how boisterous they can be, not only here at home, but also we know now they travel.
Havoc leader Abby causing some disruption on the free throw line, as she did at Cameron Indoor. Took some heat on Twitter. But she played a huge role at Duke.
She took heat?
Yeah, people were giving her a hard time for screaming.
Hater.
Yeah. Terrible.
GCU, though, they've put up a little advantage here, but offensively, it really hasn't been as crisp and clean, I don't think, from the starting group that Coach Marley would like. He can Kerwin Smith back up off the bench. He was fantastic in that first half. He's getting him back in his basketball game. The next dead ball.
Given moving up over. Vernon doesn't go. Freyer pulled down the rebound. Up for Russell. Quickly, Fifi drives baseline underneath. Draws the foul. Doesn't hit the bucket.
If you learn to start finishing those plays with contact, I think sometimes that contact, his concentration just dips just enough where he's not able to finish the basket. And one in the first half, he couldn't quite get down. I think it was Kerwin Smith that followed it up. But see a lot of good flashes from this young player.
He'd be looking sharp, his 12th point. Perfect. 7 of 7 from the free throw line.
Barry, you're always asking me questions about the game. Let me ask you a question. What does it say about the WAC in New Mexico State to get that win at ASU tonight on the road?
It's huge. You know, and of course, Marvin Menzies leaving to go to UNLV, and Coach Weir stepping in. Pascal Siakam playing for the Toronto Raptors. They're doing a great job. They've got a couple of big victories here back to back. So that conference, and your buddy Mark Pope up at Utah Valley, the Wolverines playing really well. We know what Bakersfield and Coach Barnes is doing. So there's improved play in this conference.
Turnaround for Vaughn, and it goes. Washa Vaughn.
Oh my goodness, I tell you what, a number of these Mississippi Valley State players have gotten some athletic spin moves in that peanut area now. As you saw Phillips and Searles and Riley all get inside there and have some success against that GCU defense, generally against taller players. Taught that spin move. I'm always impressed by the spin move, Barry, because that's one move I could never do.
Spin move and then be poised enough to either shoot or to dish. Have your bearings. Another junior called for the personal foul. Martin, open look, 3-point attempt. Oh, short rebound. Pulled down by Vaughn. To the left, Phillips. Freyer eyeing him. Looked inside, went right. Vaughn back out even further to Riley. Darryl Riley looking over to Coach Payne for the instruction. Hands it over to Isaac Williams. Williams driving on Fifi Adu. Shot is short. Pulled down underneath by Watson.
Foul underneath. Kerwin Smith.
Kerwin didn't box out Watson. Now Watson got two early fouls and spent a lot of time on that bench where Coach Payne didn't come back with him, but that message was received. He's using his length around that basket, now getting that offensive putback, offensive rebound, and foul now opportunity knocks down that first free throw. So making the most of his minutes here in the second half.
Watson came in 20% from the free throw line, 2 of 10. Connects on the front end. Bit of an air ball in the second. Havocs don't even need to be here.
All fans, it doesn't matter if it's the Havocs or the older group or the young kids, they all love yelling air ball at the free throw line when the one was airmailed up there.
Jack Carr in the game for Freyer. Inside, Martin back out, Russell for three. Connects!
Dwayne Russell now with 3 3-point shots here in this basketball game. I like that one right there because he didn't go hunting it. Let the ball find him.
Riley shot, big rebound pulled down by Martin, up for Russell. Russell threads a needle, dishes back out. Carr drives baseline, underneath, Jared Martin, easy put back.
Oh, that's some good basketball now. The Lopes just doing a little Harlem Globetrotter routine there. Inside, outside, back to the drive, and then a dish underneath to the open guy cutting down the left side of the lane, Jared Martin there. Jared Martin's having a heck of a basketball game here now. He got himself 13 points. 4 of 8 shooting, 4 of 4 from free throw line, and 5 boards, a couple of assists, and he's giving up his body on the defense, and then he's taking a charge.
Phillips, Riley. Down in the corner. Phillips beyond the arc. Long three at the buzzer. Oh.
Go back to this first one here. I love this for the skip pass there against that zone defense. Russell doesn't have to hunt his shot. Martin's so good at finding guys out on the floor. And then Shaq Carr with a nice dish to Martin. So he giveth and he receive. On 2 consecutive possessions, good job playing team basketball. That's what you like to see. I think in the first half, guys were a little disjointed, and that zone defense rattled for that first 5, 6.5 minutes. And now, all of a sudden, they're settling down. They get through that half court, three-quarter court zone defense very easily.
Freyer's three, short. Williams pulled down the rebound. Delta Devils 1 of their last 8 from the field.
They start out the second half 3 of 6, really cooled off here.
Vaughn in the paint, dishes off. Shot hits the side of the backboard, pulled down by Martin. It's Javon Smith, misses underneath. Kerwin Smith puts it home and draws the foul.
Smith's laughing a little to himself. I think he wanted to elevate the dunk that ball. Had a little bit of a power out, just didn't get above the floor as I would like, but got the foul and somehow I think hit underneath the bottom of the rim and it crawled up over the top of the rim, hit the backboard and fell in softly.
Lopes opening it up here in the second half on a 7-0 run. The last 1:33, it's 60-37.
GCU offers more than 200 innovative programs across 9 colleges, which now include cutting-edge next-generation programs in engineering, computer science, and information technology. Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu. Christmas from Grand Canyon University.
There's a surge of excitement at GCU as the Lopes gear up for greatness. We do not accept defeat. We will not disappoint. We will not quit. We are the intensity brewing in the heart of Phoenix. We are the Lopes rising. Come watch us defend our house against Louisville, San Diego State, and rival New Mexico State.
Catch all the family-friendly entertainment. Games will sell out. Get your basketball season tickets today at LopesTickets.com.
GCU Arena, Be Kind America performing right now with just under 12 to play. GCU with a 23-point lead over Mississippi Valley State. You're watching Free TV, and I'm Kate Longworth bringing you scores from around the WAC. UTRGV coming out on top, 95-81 the final there. West Virginia also winners tonight. The Mountaineers taking care of UMKC. DePaul gets the W tonight after falling to UIC earlier in this week. And guys, the one I've got my eye on is the final over at ASU as New Mexico State took the W 87-70. Now, Sun Devils don't match up head-to-head with GCU this year, but we'll see how it goes when GCU matches up with New Mexico State. You can compare those final scores.
Always a great matchup. The Hokes knock it off New Mexico State here a year ago. Pruitt-Smith connects. Three-point play for Kerwin. 11:45 and counting.
Smith's done a good job here tonight. You know, he got the 9 points in the game. He's got six boards. He's doing a good job defensively, trying to shut down that middle.
Drawing the foul underneath.
Ball call on the Lopes, number 21.
Kerwin Smith.
Third personal, fourth team foul.
So the Delta Devils haven't scored a point here in just over 2 minutes, 2:03 to be exact. One of their last nine from the field. Well, the Lopes are on an 8-0 run in the last minute 47.
I think what Coach Marley said to them at halftime, defense resonated throughout his team. They certainly ratcheted up here in the second half, getting after them, taking away a lot of those easy points they got inside.
Isaac Williams, the senior. 77% free throw shooter coming in. Connects. Martin takes it from Shaq Carr. Tied by Watson, back to Carr. They need to get it past center court. Carr does it. Whoa, look out.
Well, you wonder why the Delta defense has stayed in that three-quarter press. I mean, they've gotten now 8 turnovers from GCU. Not a huge number, but the turnovers that they want to get are the ones that lead to easy opportunities the other way because they have trouble scoring. The ones that go out of bounds like that and they have to inbounds don't hurt the Lopes as much. They're able to recover from those and set their own defense.
Shaq Carr with his team leading 29th turnover. And the errant pass to Russell goes out of bounds. Been a little sloppy here with a pretty good cushion.
You see that dip a little bit, right? You get that 20-point advantage, and teams will try to get a little sloppy. I think one did mention about that Harlem Globe try to tie up action. Now, they feel that when they're on the floor, they want more of that. And Russell tried to grab that ball with one hand and flip it back to his trail man, and he's the one that really lost that. Some of that's on Shaq Carr, but you got to give Russell a little bit of that turnover, too.
Up over the top of Kerwin Smith, Jamal Watson.
Watson's looked good here in the second half. Only had 4 minutes because of that foul trouble that first half, but come back here in the second half, he's looking strong on the offensive end.
Breyer comes out. Martin now, top of the key to the right. Shaq Carr into Kerwin Smith. Backing in on Watson. Goes left, goes high, draws the foul. And Watson, as you mentioned, early foul trouble.
Yeah, and that's kind of a silly foul by Watson. You got to know Kerwin Smith is a right-handed player. You take away that left-hand shoulder turn, there's no way you want him turning back the left shoulder. And Coach Payne's over there coaching him up. It's the exact same thing. And then when you reach out with your arms and you don't get him back up by your ears, that's going to be easy call by the official. But if he'd have got his hands back a little bit, even after a poor footwork team there defensively, still could have avoided at least a foul trouble.
Watson has 4 personal fouls. One thing, if you're a Delta Devil fan, I mean, this coach gives it everything he has. Coach Payne, he's teaching, he's supporting. Definitely active. You see him right there.
I don't believe he sat down all game, has he?
I don't think so. Worked there by Henry. Draws the foul on Jared Martin.
Again,
give Henry some credit right here. He pulled up against the best defender, and Jared Martin got a step on him, got the foul call. Henry's been struggling a little bit here offensively. Hasn't got himself to the scoring column. He's only taken the one shot, and that was his first free throw attempt, so he's stuck on that launch pad tonight.
Rajay Henry from Queens, New York. Carr, cross court, fire! Pelos!
That's a nice job there, catching that ball and looking opposite, and Frere knows what to do with it on the break.
Comes back to court and pulls down the rebound. Carr, driving in the paint. Ooh. Almost lost the ball. Travel.
Yeah, he double dribbled. Same thing as a travel call as he got tied up, got a little too deep. But I love that one there, that little cross-court look. Finds his other buddy running that left wing. Oscar Frere really likes, he likes that one-hand dunk where he gets full extension before slamming it home.
Henry down low underneath, easy bucket. Isaac Williams.
They just lost Isaac Williams on that play.
Frere.
Didn't seem like anybody was guarding him whatsoever. He's just 2 points he's going to have on the season.
20-point lead for the Lopes. Russell, three. Bam!
That's an aspect of Russell's game that he's at, being able to play off that basketball and come off of those down screens, curling back up to the top.
19 for Dwayne Russell. Searles. Tied by Frere. Goes to his left where he finds Henry. Henry trying to drive on Martin. Goes up over the top.
Yeah, he's able to get the corner on Martin a couple times now. I think Martin's getting a little too upright. Got to get a little lower to the ground. Be able to slide those biscuits, stay in front of those drivers.
Frere. Three. Ooh, rings out. Pulled down by Watson. Ooh, Watson up to Searles. Frere. Gibbon. Gibbon in the paint. Dishes back out. Searles going to try for three. Rebound is high. Oop, off the fingertips of Smith. Goes into the hands of Isaac Williams in the bucket. Russell to Carr. Back into Dwayne's hands. A little careful. Almost lost it. Searles was there. Give an eye on him. Smith comes out. Frere inside Kerwin Smith.
Oh, Kerwin called that on Kerwin Smith. I thought he did a nice job with the pick and then roll it to the basket. He got the flip back pass to create a better angle to throw it into Smith, but obviously saying Smith too much off arm.
Fourth personal foul on Kerwin Smith. Dan Marley didn't agree with it. 67-48 is the score. 7:51 on the clock. Second half. Oscar Frere is flying.
Founded on the belief that the entrepreneurial dream is an engine that drives innovation forward in a global marketplace, the Colangelo College of Business educates and develops values-driven business leaders. Our graduates exemplify the principles of servant leadership and entrepreneurship. GCU's strong Christian identity informs the education you receive, integrating our Christian values with the business curriculum. The college features more than 25 programs from the bachelor through the master's level, catering to traditional, evening, and online students. These programs serve a diverse set of aspiring business professionals who not only learn in the classroom, but gain real-world experience operating actual businesses. Our students also receive unique access to Jerry Colangelo's legendary experience, leadership, and connections throughout the business world. Find out more at gcu.edu/business.
I am Laura Lozoya, and I am majoring in biology with an emphasis in pre-med at Grand Canyon University. The dorm life at GCU definitely helped me build relationships, and I've made great friends on this campus. The quality education here is great. You're testing your limits, but you're going beyond them. It all comes together, the sciences, the ethics, and just everything. It's a beautiful thing.
Grand Canyon University, the quality of a private Christian education, the affordability of a state university. Visit gcu.edu.
Barry Butel, Scott Williams, Kate Longworth at GCU Arena with the Lopes lead at 67-48. How about Jared Martin with 13 points this evening?
Now he's done just about everything. He's joining Russell as the only Lope player to play every minute of this basketball game. He's taking advantage of his opportunities. He offensively gets that three ball to go down. He hasn't shot the ball great from behind the arc, but that's what he's done really well. Knifing to the basket. He's 4 of 8 from the field. He's got himself fouled from going inside a few times. He's 4 of 4 from the foul line. He's got himself 6 boards. He's been on that glass. 1 offensive rebound, 13 points. We talked about the 3 assists. I love the only fact that he takes care of the basketball when he got it. He makes a simple pass. Only turned it over once in 32 minutes. And oh, by the way, 2 steals and a draw charge.
Season high 13. Jared Martin at 10 at Duke. Watson to his right. Henry to his right, Searles. Down low, turnaround quickly, doesn't drop for Williams.
Then they got Gibbons underneath, pushing Frere in the back. Coach Payton doesn't like it at all, but I think it was the right call. Frere had that inside position. And that is going to be the 9th team foul on the Delta Devils, and sent Frere to the line here for the 1 and 1.
Air short, rebound is up high. Kerwin Smith grabbing after it. Williams able to keep it in. Williams high off the glass. Did Henry try to put it back? Gibbons there. My goodness.
Hard working basket right there. I give the Delta Devils a lot of credit for that one. He stayed after it.
Lead is 17 for the Lopes. Jack Carr to his right. This is back. Martin down. Oh, he tried to thread the needle. Ill-advised.
Just what I say, he makes a simple pass. Comes in here trying to make the spectacular pass, and they turn it over for the 12th time this evening.
Would have been better if he just shot it.
Yeah, right. Get a season high going. Yeah. Keep it going. Go for 20 tonight.
Williams. Henry on Martin. Goes right hand off the glass. And in.
Well, Martin's starting to get a little tired. Yeah, he plays a lot of minutes generally, but you have to play every minute, especially when you're playing against this zone defense. You have to work a little bit harder. You look, he doesn't have to feel like he's got the legs on his shot. And defensively, he's certainly noticeably slower. His 3 players now have gotten by him to the bucket.
Russell stopping, popping, and in. You got to think maybe he's going to head on out. Martin as Fifi and Keontae Vernon at the scorer's table waiting to come in.
Yeah, the nation's third leading scorer, Dwayne Russell, now up again over the 20-point plateau once again. 7 of 11 shooting. He's got 21 points.
Williams pulled down by Frere was the rebound up for Shaq Carr. Under 6 to go.
Frere's doing some work on that glass. Yeah, it's the second half. 6 boards for Frere here. Most of those coming in the second period.
Russell, 3-point attempt. Oh, off the mark, pulled down by Tajay Henry. Quickly up the court. Oh, that's a long shot. Picked up, Russell. Russell goes to his right. Jared Martin, 3-point attempt. Short. Smith pushes it way out. Searles able to grab it in. Moving up on Shaq Carr. Lays it in.
They got some tired low players on the floor right now. I think Martin's out of gas and Russell's out of gas. Luckily for them, it's Coach Payne, the one that takes the timeout. These two guys need to get a breather.
Timeout on the floor, 5:16 to go, 69-54. You look at Searles.
Yeah, that one Smith tipped it long, and Searles got it. Russell was only about a foot or 2 steps behind and just could not put on the afterburners to run him down. Made it an easy layup for Searles on the defense, on the offensive end.
Remember, the Lopes in action here at home Tuesday and Thursday next week. Great opportunity for families to come on out to GCU Arena with the students back home for holiday break. Take a look and grab those tickets. 602-639-8979 or just log on to LopesTickets.com. Family-friendly entertainment right here in Phoenix, Arizona.
That was really not a bad seat in this house. You know, I walked up to the upper level tonight and found some fans and
gave them my season tickets as they wanted to, I upgraded them. But really not a bad seat up there.
Convenient parking.
Russell, bounce pass, Fifi. Freyer, Martin quickly. Russell, top of the circle. Pulls back, now he steps in. Martin's gonna try for three. Off the mark.
I thought that Russell and Martin would have came out during that timeout.
These two guys are still on the floor. Ooh, up over the top. Did he have his feet planted?
Offensive foul ball on the Devils, number 10, Tajay Henry.
He did. Tajay Henry fall. Good work. See the feet?
Yeah, when you just kind of lower that shoulder a little bit. That's what kind of tips the official off, that you're dislodging the defensive player off his already established position.
Philip Sine, Russell. To his left, in the corner, down low, Keontae Vernon tried to turn it around, pulled back his own rebound. There's, oh my, how did that not go?
It hasn't been Keontae Vernon tonight, so early foul trouble, just 2 points. That was the easiest two he probably would have had opportunity all game long, and just couldn't elevate high enough to get that dunk down.
How about Freyer, he got it just a little bit, but he couldn't knock the ball away, and the Delta Devils put it home.
Yeah, Henry now with 9 points on 4-6 shooting, so you already have two Mississippi Valley State players in double-figure scoring, trying to get a third one there with Henry.
69-56, foul on the floor as the Lopes in control against Mississippi Valley State. Leave it here on 3TV.
Our company's Comfortpedic Inc. We're a local mattress company here. It's a small family business that my dad started. Now we are providing the dorm mattresses to the most recent dorms here at GCU. One of my professors, he was a professor for my junior year, Paul Waterman, he was the one that started everything. Without him, like, this wouldn't have been possible. I came up with a short presentation, a quick business pitch. I present to Dr. Gibb with my company history, and he loved it. So first we started with the hotel mattresses. Brett Courtwhite was very helpful, and everything ran smoothly. From there, we began with the dorm mattresses. We asked them what exactly they were looking for in a dorm mattress, and that's when we started to come up with a prototype. We brought in one of the mattresses that GCU currently has. We opened it up. We saw where they needed improvement and what we could do best to, like, maximize a better prototype, and we came up with the mattresses that we have now, and after that everything ran pretty smoothly, thankfully. You can see the community thriving along with GCU, and just the fact that GCU was willing to buy locally from a company that's only 10 minutes away, you can tell that they really want the community to grow with them. I'm very proud to say I'm a Lope, and I tell it to everyone, like, go to GCU, Lopes up. I'm very, very proud.
That's blasting in here. And the other day, Sean Miller commenting on how well the Havocs travel. And guys, they got national praise at NCAA.com. You can check out that article. But Lopes making things happen on the court and off the court as well.
Yeah, nice to see that article on NCAA.com today. Bleacher Reports had some great articles come out recently talking about this program in its fourth and final year of D1 transition. Before they're tournament eligible,
They've earned all of that, though. They've been a hard-working team. They haven't let these injuries derail their season, what their mission statement is as a program.
Defensive wall was put up by the Lopes. Freyer in the corner. Martin. Russell. Yeah, the Havoc's getting a lot of accolades, but shout out to Taylor Griffin, Helen Bleach from GCU putting on the show here. The events, fantastic. Best in college basketball. And their staff. Russell. Ooh, short. Hits the front of the rim, kicked back out.
A lot of short shots by Russell and Martin hitting the front of that rim. When you see that, you start to think the player's legs, they're not engaging the lower part of their body. That's where those long shots are generated from, the lower half of your body, not your arms. And they are shooting all arms right now, and they're coming up short as a result.
Russell right. Freyer, Martin driving. Back to Freyer, three-point attempt. Off the mark. Pulled down by Watson. Up for Searles. Rashawn Searles underneath, battling, losing the handle, loose ball. Watson's there, Fifi Adu on the run. He gets his pocket picked by Searles. Bounce pass. Williams. Oh, that was quite a turn of events.
Yeah, Isaac Williams was one of the players we thought were going to be in the starting lineup. He was struggled from the three-point line. They knew he needed his scoring tonight. Couldn't get himself going in that first half. He was just 4-21 behind the arc, but he knocked that one down. We got an 11-point ball game, 2 minutes to play. It's not over just yet.
Martin. Fifi. Hinted at the three. Russell to his right. He'll put the floater. But Vernon's there! Bam!
Oh, welcome to the party, pal. Vernon. Hadn't done much of anything all night long. He's been getting some rebounds, got six boards, but that was just a second field goal in spectacular fashion, following up the Russell miss floater.
Oh, look who woke up. Isaac Williams for three. Ten-point Lopes lead.
I think that dunk by Keontae Vernon might have been the final nail in the coffin. Coach Payne's got those guys sit back there. He obviously not going to foul here, try to extend this game. Just going to let this game clock run out.
Fifi Adu, short. Freyer. Russell. Ooh, look at that. We're ahead of Duffy Fowler.
Yeah, we didn't need Russell going into that bench and getting injured. No. That would have been horrible. Too many guys over there in street clothes and hoodies already. And I love his effort, but that one by Keontae Vernon, I think that was one of those frustration. He had a little angry intentions behind dunking that one. You got to get more consistency out of Keontae Vernon. DC is going to be on the shelf for the next couple weeks. Keontae Vernon is going to have to step up and provide more interior offense and more rebounding and being able to stay out of foul trouble. Been talking about it for a solid year and a half. The silly fouls that are unnecessary that send him to the bench just cannot happen here, certainly in the next couple weeks without DC, but even after DC comes back when they go into whack play.
Game is given at the line. 56% free throw shooter coming into action. Big rebound up over the top was Searles. I'm a little confused at how that was called as Searles swatted it out of bounds. We'll see if the officials change it up. Both of the coaches are going to bring their troops together while the officials back at the video monitor. Had plenty of these reviews.
If you're GCU, wouldn't you just say, hey, we'll give the ball to them. We've got a 10-point cushion, 48 seconds to play. They're not trying to foul to stop the clock.
Well, it didn't take a long time.
That's good. Sometimes those things take too long, as we've had a couple of them go what seemed like between an eternity, 5 or 7 minutes, but that's good. They got a quick look at it, made a determination. Let's play ball.
You see Darian Clark there, that right arm in a sling. Josh Braun coming back from meniscus surgery. Yikes. Matt Jackson to his left, back hip surgery. There you, Boubacar Touré on the left. his knee. Also surgery there.
It's Cartore was walking. He was rocking that gold nugget there, wasn't he? Popping that thing out of his hoodie.
Wow. And so Nudo's back from an Achilles. He looks good, but he'll be strong at the start of next season. Look out, Kenzo Nudo from three-point land next year. Six on the shot clock. Martin quickly, Freyer better shoot. Aaron shot, not there. Ooh, careful, Fifi almost. Williams underneath, Gibbon tried to put it back. Fifi takes it. They're gonna have to foul or do something or just give it up as there's eight left. Payne said forget about it, step away. The Wolves are gonna win their sixth of the season. 10-point victory for GCU. They beat the Delta Devils 72-62 here at GCU Arena. Obviously, a big victory for the Lopes. Probably one Coach Miley's not overly excited about as far as how his team played here, but a win is a win.
Yeah, there were some bright spots. It wasn't a clean game, but he'll take that, throw it on the win column with the rest of them, and he'll try to get these guys that had to go 40 minutes tonight some rest before they have to take the floor again on Tuesday.
So Dwayne Russell leads all scorers in the game with 22 points, 3 assists, 1 rebound for Dwayne Russell, who definitely is, boy, what a season he has had for the Wolves. 42 points against Louisville. Kate Longworth looks like she is alongside Zero the Hero, Dwayne Russell.
All right, thank you guys. Well, first and foremost, what's it feel for the team to be over that 500 mark in the sixth win of the season? And
that means a lot because, you know, we played a lot of good competition. So just so much we fought with all the injuries we had. So we're fighting right now.
Yeah, are you feeling the pressure with all these injuries to really go out there and carry the team? We see you doing that, really doing it in all areas. Your leadership and, of course, scoring tonight 22 points. Are you feeling that pressure or relishing it?
I'm really not feeling a lot of pressure. Coach Marty doesn't put a lot of pressure on me. He just tells you go out here and just play as hard as I possibly can. So the pressure, I don't really feel it that much.
Yeah, it looks like you're actually, you know, taking what's at hand for you, the challenge, rising to the occasion. But what's it mean to this team? You guys have been going up against some tough competitors, but getting a lot of praise. Are you hearing that outside chatter, and what does it mean to this program?
We're really not trying to listen to the outside chatter too much. We're just trying to get better every game or whatever. And, you know, we've been losing, so we're trying to get some wins. Yeah.
It's hard to think of you guys losing because I know the score hasn't always reflected it, but you're going out there playing some amazing competitors and really matching their level out there. What are you taking away from those games when I know you don't get the W you want?
You know, we're just taking away the fact that we can compete against anybody. So, you know, we're just going to take that confidence leading into WAC play.
All right. Well, it was the W tonight. So congratulations, and we'll see you out here
thank
on
you,
Tuesday.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right. Zero the Hero, certainly the hero tonight, as he continues to be each and every night for the Lopes. Guys.
Thank you, Kate. 22 points for Dwayne Russell. 4 of 5 from the free throw line. 7 of 14. As Zero the Hero leads the way again.
Well, I like the way that, you know, the team was a little struggling to get off the launch pad. He had to come in there. He knocked in 2 3-point shots in that first half, came back with a third in the second half, but was an attack mode offensively. Didn't search for the best of 12, let it find him. I love the way Martin is able to deliver strikes when he comes off of those down screens and the curls to the top of the floor. So very effective job shooting 50% from the field. I said 3 3-pointers, make that 4 3-pointers.
12 points in the second half for Dwayne Russell from Peoria, Arizona. He has really carried this team with a number of injuries, including Josh Braun, the preseason WAC selection for player of the year. Hopefully Josh will be back for the start of conference play in January. A lot of kids looking up to Dwayne Russell as he is a stalwart here and the leader of the GCU Lopes. The Alcorn Braves of the Southwestern Athletic Conference come into the GCU Arena to try to knock off the Lopes next Tuesday evening. GCU defeated the Braves last season at home in their season opener. Alcorn State led by 6'5 junior Reginald Johnson, averaging 14.6 points per game, up nearly 8 from a season ago.
Join Kate Longworth for the Lopes pregame show starting at 6:30. Tip off shortly after at 7. Watch Alcorn State versus GCU next Tuesday night on the CW6, online at GCU.tv, or on iHeartRadio with Tom Kuiper and Michael Potter. That'll do it from here at GCU Arena, where the Lopes beat the Delta Devils from Mississippi Valley State 72-62. Please join us again on Tuesday. GCU hosting Alcorn State. With Scott Williams, Kate Longworth, Tim Ring, and our entire crew from Phoenix, I'm Barry Butel, wishing you a wonderful evening.